Hello everyone. After a few online races in Project Cars 2 and as the course side, it's time to do some career. Still at tier 5, though I could do tier 4, but the reason I'm tier 5 because I want to finish that European Championship to get the accolade. So two more runs left, round 4 at Oschersleben and round 5 at Bugatti, Le Mans Bugatti. So difficulty. My initial testing showed that for that truck I need 100. We'll see how it works. I will keep the aggressiveness at 70 and let's start. Practice first, just to get some feeling of the car, the truck again, and to see how the AI will behave at 170 aggressiveness. They can be too aggressive even at 70. I used to run at 100, but it was pointless.
Go, go, go!
Steady on the outlap. Tire temps are still low.
Twenty-eight degrees truck temperature, that's quite a good truck temp. So to get some heat into the tires. They are 40 degrees at the moment, quite cold. yeah, no point. So I'm going to return to pit box and drive again. I won't be restarting, there's plenty of time. Temperature is growing really slowly. It starts at 25 degrees. I had it around 40 when I crashed. I let them drive because they're on the flying lap. I'm just on my out lap. There's one more car coming. That's the first lap, that's my first lap in terms of out lap. The tires are still super cold, 46 degrees, 51 the warmest one, so I need more laps to get the tires to the good working temperature. Oh my, I was close. That headphones cable is really annoying. I had to connect them because they're dying. Oh, screw that. Cannot drive with that. Not sure what is going on here. Driving horribly. bit too wide there, so the time was invalidated, but it doesn't matter that much. I just want to see what kind of time I can do. .134. Not sure how that compares to AI at the moment. Left front is the only warm tire. That would be 133.7, but as I said, it was also invalidated, so let's hope for this lap. Too fast. I really wanted to go there really fast, but unfortunately I went too wide. Second with 133.888. Interesting time. The guy in front of me is actually the first one at the moment. Three out of four tires are warm up now. Rear right is still cold. 69 degrees, so just 1 degree below what's considered a good working temperature, though 70 is still quite cold. I like to have them around 90, which I have 89 on the left front, 77 right front, 75 rear left. And that's first place at the moment.
Hit confirm, we're setting up for that now.
Okay, that 32 was one of. I don't expect to do times in 32. 33 is more likely. Again, there's a big difference between the second guy and the others of them. So I'm going to skip to the end. Continue to qualifying. I think I will increase the difficulty just a little bit. So let me exit out of the game. Increase the difficulty by 2, 102. Save and start. And it's qualifying. Now I will take a bit more fuel because I need at least 2-3 laps to warm up the tires. They start really cold, 25 degrees, and it's really hard to warm them up. Though it's quite warm on the track during the qualifying session, it is 33 degrees Celsius on the track. So that's actually quite nice. It may help with warming up the tires. We'll see. That car is a complete different beast on the cold and warm tires. It has no grip whatsoever in the medium speed and fast speed corners. But once those tires will warm up, I should be able to do some reasonable lap times.
Let's take pole position with this lap.
No chance.
Try not to lock up at the braking. You can do this.
Not on this lap. Maybe on a third or fourth lap, that would be a higher chance of setting up quite a good lap time. It's still sliding quite a lot. The rear tires are still a bit too cold. Especially in those two corners, it's really hard to keep it on track. .446. That's what I was doing before I raised the difficulty. So after the difficulty was risen, they should be doing better times. I'm already second, so yeah, they're definitely doing better times than that. But I should be able to improve once I've got more heat in the tires. Unfortunately, the rear went loose again and I lost some time in those fast right and left hander corners. I improved though, but just a little bit. I'm third at the moment. I'm fourth, the guy in front of me is fifth. I improved in the first sector a little bit. And that's pole position.
Pit confirm, we're setting up for that now.
I improved significantly in that last lap. It was 1 minute 32.339. I'm not pushing anymore, obviously, because I'll be going to pit anyway. There we go, I return to pit box. It was, that is really interesting. The second one has exactly half a second worse time than mine. The third is exactly 1 second behind, then it's 1 second and 2,000 of a second, 1 second and 17,000 of a second, 28. Wow, very close, very close. Don't feel like waiting for that to finish, so I'm going to skip to end and I'll continue to race and let's see what kind of conditions the game prepared for us for that race. It looks like it's sunny, forecast is clear. 25 degrees Celsius ambient and 34 degrees Celsius track temperature. 10 laps. I'm not sure how much fuel I should take. I think this is already the setup for the fuel I need. Hopefully. Because I don't remember. So I will take a risk and let's start the race.
Ready, mate. Focus on the light. Think about the run into the first corner. Protect your lead into turn one. not won 2 lengths back.
Let's see what kind of surprises this race has for us. I'm sure there will be some. To try to keep the tires warm. I have 0.9 seconds advantage at the moment after the first lap. Again, a little bit in those fast corners, in those S's, not much, but still. Push it to 1.5 seconds at the moment. Even 1.8 now. It looks like I'm much faster in that sector 3. I did really fast lap, I didn't expect that. 1 minute 31.8. I've never went below 1 minute 32.
Awesome in the first sector, that's your best split so far.
It has to be those warm up tires. The temperature rise, so it's easier to drive that car. Or maybe I set it too early. Oh, I kept it in. I was super risky. And it definitely cost me some time. But that's what it is in racing, a moment of the concentration and you go south. Minute 32.8. It is still faster than expected. I was expecting 1 minute 33 low. So definitely the track conditions are better than I assumed they will be. I thought it would be colder, as usually it is in that series, which is really annoying. So at least for once we got a good racing conditions. Really? Okay. I'll find a way to do it. Bloody thing is not disappearing. And then I'll get a new one. Maybe not. Lucky me. But I need to focus more. My driving is very messy at the moment. 33.7, but at least that's the time I was expecting to do. Bit of oversteer there. As a slow corner, second gear, it's easy to overpower that car. Lap 7, so it's around 3.5 laps still to go. It's a 10 laps long race. had a quick look at temperatures. They're really good. 97 degrees water temp. ...104 degrees oil temperature. The only thing which is bad are the brakes. They're really cold at the moment. Now, a few laps to go. Almost 4 second advantage over a second. Nothing huge, but it's safe enough. A bit of fighting with oversteer just to keep the truck driving straight or where I want it. Two laps to go. And it's time for a final lap with 4.6 seconds advantage at the moment.
Final lap, just ease off and bring it home.
A bit too wide. It was a bit dangerous. If that one of the curbs would drop me, I could have gone off track. Yeah, you can see it costed me quite a lot of time. A very small mistake, nothing big. And here it is. End of race. Just a cool down lap. Get that car to the pit lane. Park it at my pit stop. And have a quick look at the results. Just to see how my team made it. Almost killed the guy there.
Fantastic drive.
Perfect. And here we go. First place, my teammate was 7th. So together it will be good points. Oh, I also had the fastest lap, that 31.839. I haven't checked all the drivers, unfortunately, so I don't know how that compares. Where's my teammate? Here it is, 6 points. So altogether it's 32 points with that fastest lap. It's 2 points more than the next team. Good, good. So I myself, after four rounds, won three times and had three podiums. I was out of podium once. I don't remember now which track it was, but I have a good advantage in terms of points. I already won the championship, even if I didn't drive the last race. And I think we also won this championship as a team. 65, they can get 25 plus, what is it, 18? 26 plus 18. Cool. Well, I'll still drive the last race, but not today. I'll leave it for later or maybe for tomorrow. The last race is Le Mans Bugatti circuit. So it's the short version of Le Mans. It actually just uses a few corners of the Le Mans racetrack. Not too many. I think the first chicane, the fourth chicane, and then it turns right instead of going straight as the Le Mans circuit, then it drives in the infield of the Le Mans racetrack, and then it joins the Le Mans track just after the fourth chicanes. Oh, no, the fourth chicanes are the last chicanes, so I'm not sure what that's the Dunlop Bridge, okay. So the first part is Dunlop Bridge, and the last part are the just past the fourth chicanes. So it's just really the start finish straight line of the Le Mans racetrack. Okay, great. Thank you all for watching and have a good weekend. And I'll see you next time when I'll be driving the last race of the Formula C European Championship. And then I'll be moving to the Tier 4, which is Formula Renault.